Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are discussing a parabola and this is video lecture number 10. I hope you have already watched part 1 to part 9 before watching part 10. And we are discussing a parametric equation on parabola, tangent in form of parametric equation, normal in form of parametric equation. So tangent, parametric equation of tangent on parabola. What is that? So any point T, any point T on parabola, is what? Is AT square comma 280, AT square comma 280 on what? On y square is equal to 4ax, 4ax is AT square comma 280. So equation of this is a parabola and point T on parabola is like this, right? T is a point, AT square comma 280. So equation of tangent at parabola T is what? This is the axis of parabola, this is a tangent, P and P is a point, so PT is a tangent and PN is a normal, right? This is a normal and if I say this is a subtangent, we have learned in the last class, and subnormal as well. So here we want to learn the equation of tangent at T. Equation of tangent at T on parabola is what? Y1, we have learned this, that y square should be replaced by y1, and y, what is y1? 280. Y into 280 is equal to 2a into x plus x1, and what is x1? At square, x plus at square. 2a, 2a can be cancelled. So equation of tangent is, equation of tangent is, now what is that? Ty is equal to x plus at square. You must remember this. Ty is equal to x plus at square. Slope of tangent is, slope of tangent is what? Slope of tangent is y given by, what is this coefficient of x? If I can write 1 by t into x plus at, then this is the slope is 1 by t. M1, say M1 is 1 by t. And slope of normal, therefore, slope of normal, normal is what? M2, which is minus 1 by M1, because M1 and 2 is equal to minus 1, that is minus t. So equation of normal at T would be, therefore, equation of normal, normal at T is given by what? Y minus Y1, that is 280, is equal to minus T, X minus X1, that is AT square, because X1 is AT square. So what will be the equation? Then this equation will come, Y is equal to minus 280, minus Px plus AT cube. And moreover, in short way we can write Px plus Y minus 280 minus AT cube is equal to 0 is the equation of normal to the parabola, is the equation of normal, normal at T. Is the equation of normal at T. Tx plus y, this is ty plus x plus at square. Here Tx plus y minus 2at minus at cube, this is the equation of normal at T. Right? So we got the equation of tangent at T, we got the equation of normal at T, and these are very, very important facts. You must remember these two equations, and if you memorize this, definitely it will be helpful for you. So now we want to find the point of intersection of T. What is this? Where is, what is the point of intersection? To find the point of intersection on x-axis, this is the x-axis, na? X-axis, axis of parabola, this is y-axis. So to find point of intersection, I should put y equal to 0. So if I put y equal to 0, memorize this, put y equal to 0 to get point of intersection on x-axis, right? So what will happen? This is the equation of tangent, and to find the point of intersection on x-axis, we put y equal to 0. We put y equal to 0. So put y is equal to 0. If I put y is equal to 0, then what will come? X is equal to minus 80 square. So the point of intersection will be minus 80 square comma 0. The point of intersection will be minus 80 square comma 0. So point of intersection of tangent, the point of intersection, therefore the point where tangent at P meets the axis of parabola, h minus 80 square comma 0, right? This is the point of intersection. And the point where normal meets, so if I to find it, y is equal to 0, x is equal to 2a plus 80 square. And the point, again, where normal meets, normal at T meets the parabola, meets the axis of parabola, is what? That is, if I put y is equal to 0, try to understand, y is equal to 0, then Tx is equal to 2a t plus 80 cube, divide by t, it will remain 2a plus 80 square. 2a plus 80 square comma 0. So these are two important points, you need to learn this and need to understand this, that this is the point of contact of tangent and point of contact of normal, right? So 2a plus 80 square comma 0, that is minus 80 square comma 0. If I will find this, what is this coordinate of m? Because this is at square comma 0, x coordinate, and this coordinate comes as 2a plus 80 square comma 0. So if I would subtract, this distance remain 2a only. Again, 2a plus 80 square minus 80 square, this distance will remain 2a, which we have discussed in the previous class also, that the length of subnormal, therefore length of subnormal, subnormal mn is equal to 2a, and length of subtangent, length of subtangent, that is tm is equal to, or mt is equal to, mt is equal to, this is 80 square, and this is one is minus 80 square, is 2a t square. As far as concerned with the length of tangents, we can do that again. Length of tangent is what? Length of tangent PP is equal to under root 80 square minus 80 square, 280 square whole square. That is 4 a square t to the power 4 and plus 4 a square t square. So if I would have taken 4 a common, then what will come? This is 2a will come outside, 2a t will come outside, and under root t square plus 1 will left, and that is the length of tangent, right? Similarly, length of normal can be calculated like Pn, and Pn is equal to nothing else but 2a minus 80 square minus 80 square, so 2a square, that is 4a square plus 0 minus 280 square, that is also 4a square t square. If I would take 2a common, then what will happen? This will be 2a, 4a square, if I would have taken common, 1 plus t square or t square plus 1. This is the length of normal. So length of tangent, length of normal all can be calculated by using this point of contact at T, and I hope you will be able to understand this, you are able to get this, and what will happen about this length of tangent and length of normal, length of subnormal, length of subtangent. These two points are very important to take care of. But if you are not able to remember this, it's okay, don't worry about that. Length of subtangent, length of subnormal, you may or may not be able to verify this. But what you need to do this is we can find the equation of tangent and equation of normal. These two equations are very, very important. You must remember this and keep in your mind. Now we will proceed for y square is equal to 4x type question mostly, because x square is equal to 4ay can be calculated accordingly. If you keep these two things together, might be some confusion created, and that is why just all this parabola will be considered for y square is equal to 4x. Wherever there is a situation of x square is equal to 4ay will come, you will use the same pattern to find all those characteristics. But if you simultaneously try to learn two different equations of tangent at t on y square is equal to 4x and x square is equal to 4ay also, it will create confusion. So that is why I am suggesting you people to analyze this and memorize this for y square is equal to 4x only, not for x square is equal to 4ay, because most of the questions will be in this pattern. And if anywhere it is in form of x square is equal to 4ay will come, you will be able to understand it easily, because concept is clear, you can derive at an instant of time. But if you try to memorize all those things together, it might create some confusion, and whenever you have to use this, might be that you are not able to use it properly. So it will be best idea to memorize these two things, and tangent of equations at t, tangent of equation of normal at t separately for y square equal to 4x. So some questions can be done on the basis of this as well, but some more characteristics of parabola can be also discussed. Let me discuss few questions on the basis of tangent of the parabola, right? For what value of, thereafter we will discuss the characteristics question. For what value of C, line y is equal to 3x plus C will be tangent to parabola y square is equal to 12x. So what value of C? We know this is a, we learn the condition that y square is equal to 4x, comparing with y square. Now we comparing with y square is equal to 4x, age b, right? Comparing with y square is equal to mx plus c. What is c? C is equal to 3, and m is equal to what? 3 also. So c we don't know, and m is equal to 3. M is equal to 3, c we don't know, and we know the condition of tangency. Condition of tangency is what? We know c is equal to a by m. So if I put this, C is equal to A is 3, M is 3, 3 by 3 is 1. And that is a matter of hardly 4-5 seconds that you understand that A is 3, M is 3, and C is equal to A by M. So 3 by 3 would be 1. Hardly it takes 1 second to find the answer of this question, and C must be equal to 1. No need to derive it from A, B initio. What we did, that is a conceptual. So every point what I am writing here in bracket, just you need to learn it, memorize it, because it will be used properly and you can solve questions in seconds only. I am discussing all these questions with derivation and all, just to develop the concept. But once the concept is developed, you can use it very frequently, and definitely you will be able to solve bigger questions in quick seconds only. So try to analyze this, Thereafter, I will give you also some sort of techniques in which you can derive the equations and find the job. But before that, just go with this, some process. This is a concept building process I am dealing here. Tricks and techniques I will discuss separately after some time. So, here is another question for you. What is the current value of m for which y is equal to mx minus 3 will be tangent to parabola x square is equal to 8y? That is the condition. So again, you know that what is a here? A is 2. What is c here? Minus 3. And you know condition of tangency is c is equal to minus m square. So c is minus 3 minus a is 2. And m square is what? We don't know. M square we don't know. So this cancel. And therefore m square is equal to 3 by 2. And m must be equal to plus minus under root 3 by 2. Anything can happen and any one of them can satisfy. So there are two value of m can come because c is equal to minus m square. Putting this value, I am able to get this answer. So two answers may come. Now, another questions, find the equation of tangent, to the parabola, 2y square is equal to 9x, 2y square is equal to 9x at point 1, 18, 1, 18, 18, 1, point is 18, 1, x is 2, 1, so y square is equal to x1, or 2, 2, find the point of intersection at 2, 3. Find the equation of tangent at point 2, 3. Now, you know the equation of tangent, how to derive? How to derive the equation of tangent? Y square replaced by y, y1. Y square replaced by y and y1. What is in place of y1? 3. And x, 2x must be replaced by 9 by 2 multiplied by 2. So 2x must be replaced by x plus x1. And what is x1? 2. So that is the way in which you can write the equation of this. 3 cancel this 3 times. 2 to the 4. So 4y is equal to 3x plus 6. This is the equation of parabola. Tangent to the parabola at point 2, 3. Just you need to replace x, y, replace what I did here, y square by y, y1, by y, y1, remember this, and x square by x, x1. So, and 2x here, x square was not there, but 2x by x plus x1. Or you can say x by x plus x1 by 2. So that is also applicable. You can do anything. So here what I did here, that y square replaced by y, y1, y1 is 3 and x must be replaced by x plus x1 by 2. So 3, 3 cancel and 2 multiply this side, it will be 4y is equal to 3x plus 6. So equation of tangent at any point can be determined by using this fact and you will be able to answer such questions in quick seconds if you memorize this fact. And here one more question. Find the equation of tangent to the parabola x square is equal to 3y plus 2 at point 3y plus 1 at point 4, 5. Find the equation of tangent to the parabola x square is equal to 3y plus 1 at point 4, 5. Why I am writing this again and again? Because the question is generated before you only. So just I am finding a point which will satisfy the parabola. If parabola will not lie on it, if point law not lie on parabola, then how tangent can be drawn? If point is somewhere else, then tangent cannot be drawn at that point. Huh? So point must be there which will satisfy the equation. So in my mind, I am just trying to find a point which will satisfy. If I put y is equal to 5 here, 5 3 are 15, 1 16, and x is equal to 4, so 4 square will satisfy. On one parabola, how many points will be there? Infinite points will be there. So at the same time, in my mind, many points coming that this will also satisfy, this will also satisfy. I'm trying to manage that one point which will certainly satisfy the equation. And therefore, now I have to find the equation of tangent to the parabola. You people might be thinking that this parabola is neither in form of x square is equal to 4ay nor in form of y square is equal to 4ax. Then how you can find this such equations and how we can find the equations of tangent at any point? But don't worry, whether it is x square is equal to 4ay or y square is equal to 4ax or any other form of parabola, I had given you the brahmastra that what was it? That y square to be replaced by yy1, y plus y1, x, y square to be replaced by yy1, x square to be replaced by xx1. So this point to be considered is like x1, y1. So x square must be replaced by xx1, and here the equation of tangent would be equation of tangent would be what? X square replaced by xx1. X1 is what? 4. X1 is 4. 3. Y to be replaced by 2y to be replaced by y plus y1. So y to be replaced by y plus 5 y1 upon 2. This is what? And plus 1. So this will be 2 will come this side and this will be 4 to ja a to x is equal to 3y plus 15 plus 2 and ja 2 as well. Because after doing this, this will come. So equation of tangent will be 8x minus 3y minus 17 is equal to 0 is the equation of tangent. Is the equation of tangent at point 4, 5 to the parabola. Suppose someone wanted to find the equation of normal. So no need to remember this equation, or if you can remember this equation, you can do that. Or otherwise, you can find here slope of tangent is, what is slope? 8/3. 3y is equal to, because we can write that this equation can be written like 3y is equal to 8x minus 17, and that will be y is equal to 8/3 into x minus 17/3. So this is a slope. Slope of tangent is this. So slope of normal age minus 3/8, right? And now equation of normal age, then equation of normal will be what? y minus y1 is equal to minus 3/8 x minus x1, that is x minus 4. So that will be 8y minus 14 is equal to minus 3x plus 12, and finally the equation will come like what? Equation will come like 3x plus 8y is minus 52 is equal to 0. So that is the equation of normal. Although I have not asked in this question that you have to find the equation of tangent and normal as well, but I have asked here equation of tangent, so that was enough. But I just wanted to tell you how you can derive the equation of normal as well. If anywhere any type of question is given, whether this equation is parallel to x-axis or parallel to y-axis, or if there is no parallel to x-axis or y-axis, in that case also you can use this concept to find the equation of tangent and normal to the parabola, right? Using this. I hope you got it. Right now? Okay. So this all things can be derived, concept to understand how to find the equation of tangent and how to find the equation of normal at any point on the parabola. If someone has asked you to find the equation of tangent, you can use it like this. Otherwise, you can use the formula as well. So hopefully, you got the sub points and it is clear now. And some characteristics of parabola I have to discuss, that we will discuss in the next upcoming classes, right? And many characteristics of parabola are there, and on the basis of that, usually questions ask in IITJ main advance as well. So that will be very, very important one. This is what we are doing right now. This is a concept building process, so it takes some time to analyze, to understand the basics, the application, the understanding, everything we understand now, and now we are ready to learn some more characteristics on parabola, which will be very, very useful for solving the other type of questions in parabola. And thereafter, we will use this and we will solve it. So till then, thank you very much. All the best. God bless you. Bye bye. Until the next class.